This is the summary from the Never Bust test against basic strategy. Seven shoes, every shoe was six deck blackjack dealer standing on all 17s with no surrender, blackjack paying 3-2. Both Never Bust and basic strategy bet a single unit on every hand. It was two carbon copied shoes, one red, one blue. Never Bust was always in the red. Basic strategy was the blue. That doesn't really matter, other than just to keep the shoes from getting co-mingled. I admit, a lot of trouble on the first few shoes when I was trying to run the shoes in parallel, you know, basically at the same time. It was just, it was too much for me to process. So I learned my lesson there and got to just doing them. I would do Never Bust and then basic strategy. Much cleaner. I still made a couple mistakes, but I finally got it together. And so the results that you'll see here are adjusted from the videos, and the videos have the adjusted results in the descriptions. So when you watch my things, you should always check, or if you see a mistake, check in the description, or check the comments. That's where, you know, if you do see something, let me know, and I'll try to fix it. Most of the time, it's just an adjustment of chips. If it really screws up the flow of the cards, then I'll do it over. And in fact, shoe number two for this series, I did throw it out. I made a mistake that messed up the flow of the cards, and you know, it had to be considered invalid. So, so thank you for pointing that out. And yeah, so I'm sorry about all of the sloppiness. But I think I got it under control now. And since I'm not dealing any cards here, shouldn't have that problem. Those of you who've been watching will notice that this time I printed out the summary sheet rather than handwriting it. Hopefully next time I do it, I'll make the fonts a little bit larger. I zoomed in, so hopefully you'll be able to see it. Okay, here we go, shoe number one. And I'll also work on getting a brighter green. This is green when things are in the positive, and it'll be red, which is negative. Anyways, shoe number one, Never Bust, ended up 14 and a half units playing 50 hands. Basic strategy ended up seven and only playing 48 hands. Because Never Bust doesn't take as many cards to the player, In every situation, Never Bust played more hands per shoe. We always expect to get at least, we've always gotten at least 45 hands playing, you know, regular basic strategy. And I was starting to think that I was putting the cut card a little bit deep, and you'll see as we get through, we were consistently like well over 45 hands. We never had, so maybe I'm just a little bit off. I don't know, not a huge deal. You know, that cut card is mostly to stop or to, you know, make things harder for card counters. So anyways, you know, another thing I learned from doing this series is that apparently a lot more people than I anticipated employ Never Bust in one way or another. I understand now that there are other approaches to Never Bust. This Never Bust was simply do not hit above, you know, anything hard 12 and over. It, you know, other than that, I played by basic strategy. So for example, if you had two eights, that's a hard 16. I didn't stand on that. I would split that like you're supposed to, only when the only play left to you was a hard 12. Does that make sense? So, you know, like, obviously not like any soft hands would play according to basic strategy. Any splits would play according to basic strategy. And it, you know, that was one of the things that was hard for me in doing the test was, you know, the habit of playing basic strategy, of, you know, hitting a 12 to a dealer 10, for example. It's not popular necessarily, but it's something that you need to do, or that you condition yourself to. And you know, when you're trying to move quickly and run two shoes and deal with two different stacks of chips, you fall back. You always fall back on what you know, what you've trained. I've basically trained for basic strategy, not for never bust. So that's where those mistakes came from. Anyways, you know, from the get-go here, wow, you know, double the gains for never bust. And I'm sure that, you know, never bust players were like, see, told you, you know, you didn't bust, and you so you made more. Okay, it's fine. Shoe number two. Never bust ended with a gain of half a unit, bringing its running total right here to positive 15 out of, again, 50 hands. Basic strategy this time was up 5.5 units, raising its running total to 12.5 out of 49 hands. Okay, so, you know, you're gonna different shoes, you're gonna get different results. This time, basic strategy was doing a little better. Shoe number three. This time we saw Never Bust go down by 3 units, bringing the running total down to 12 out of 52 hands. And basic strategy again gained 5.5, bringing the running total up to 18 in 48 hands. Okay, so now, so first we had Never Bust significantly higher. Here we had Never Bust trailing basic strategy. You know, it's, you know, when we look at the comparisons of flat betting versus other systems, you know, this isn't too uncommon that, you know, one will be behind. But now you start to see something where one is losing while one is gaining. And that's what we're, you know, all of this is what I'm trying to see. I'm not necessarily trying to see, does Never Bust beat the house edge? Will it do consistently better or average out better than basic strategy or any other system, you know? And that house edge is, you know, it's pretty tight, you know, if you play proper basic strategy in the first place. Okay, so, yeah, so our, you know, losing and gaining. Okay, moving on to shoe number four. You got a big loss here for the Never Bust. You know, going down 16, taking the running total down to -4 out of 52 hands. Basic strategy up by 1.5 units, bringing the running total to 19.5 in 48 hands. Okay, so this 17.5 units on what, you know, what this should show us is, you know, how good the shoe is. You know, this was a pretty good shoe. These were decent shoes, you know, in your favor. And you'll get those when you play. You'll get good shoes, you'll get bad shoes. This was a average shoe, and Never Bust was down 16. Of course, you know, one average shoe, you know, another average shoe with an average result, it may come out different. Again, that's why I'm not running just one, running a series of seven. And, you know, people like to say, well, that's not enough. And I admit, it's probably not enough, but it starts to give us an idea. Okay. Shoe number five, we saw Never Bust coming back up a little bit with a gain of 3.5. Running total of negative half of a unit in 51 hands. Basic strategy again, gaining 7.5. It's a pretty decent shoe. Running total of 27 out of 47 hands. Okay, so it's, you know, even though Never Bust was gaining, basic strategies continuing to outpace. Shoe number six. Again, Never Bust puts on another gain of 2.5. Running total now is a positive 2 out of 50 hands. And basic strategy takes its first losing shoe from -7, running total down to just a positive 20 out of 46 hands. So, and again, like I was mentioning before, all of these are reasonably over 45. So I am putting that cut a little bit deep. So this one's kind of interesting because, you know, never, that's not a huge gain, but, you know, it's a start, or it's something, you know, in -7. So we have a delta here of 9.5 units, which is even greater than, you know, the 7.5 unit delta here in the first shoe. Okay, so, yeah, I thought that was kind of big. And as you'll see, that was the only time that basic strategy experienced a loss, as well as only the second time that Never Bust did better. So shoe 7, Never Bust was down by 4 units, so his running total ends up at minus 2 out of 50 hands. Again, basic strategy gains 11, running total up to a positive 31 out of 49 hands. So this is, you know, minus 4 to positive 11. The difference between those is 15 units. That, again, that's more now than the 9.5. So that one was a big difference. You know, a pretty good shoe. So why was it losing out here? Okay. So in the end, Never Bust is down by 2, and now that should be in red, so oops. And basic strategy up by 31. Total of 355 hands for Never Bust. Total of 335 hands for basic strategy. So as expected, we played more hands, in this case 20 more hands for Never Bust. I made this maybe too small. This is the per hand expectations based on the results. So, you know, it's minus 2 divided by 355 or 31 divided by 335. So this is a minus 0.006 per hand. So that you're expected to lose on every hand a minus 0.006 units. Which, and then for basic strategy, you gained a 0.093 per hand. So, again, that kind of, you know, these should, you know, according to, like, whatever the house edge should be, which is, you know, like 0.5% for basic strategy, and the numbers kind of vary, but maybe, like, the house edge goes up to 4% for Never Bust. You know, this is not going to be 4%, and obviously this, you're making a gain. So, this lets us know that all the shoes summed up in this series was pretty good, and you can obviously see that, you know, 6 out of 7 were winning shoes, at least 4 for basic strategy, and you know, 4 out of 3 for Never Bust were still winning shoes. So this is, I think, a little unusual. You don't usually in our other test see 6 winning shoes, you know, for our control. Usually it's, you know, I don't remember exactly through all of them, but usually get a little bit more of a mix, you know. So so the only time that we see a losing shoe, we actually had Never Bust doing better. So I kind of don't feel like I don't think our results are going to be conclusive in the first place. Let me just make that clear. Don't, you know, people keep saying things to me about that, and it's like, yes, I know it's not, but you got to start somewhere, and trying to get just, you know, a starting look at it. So because of that, I especially don't feel that this is necessarily conclusive, because we only had one losing shoe, and during that losing shoe, Never Bust did better. However, if you're looking at, you know, at the end result, that is a difference of 33 units. $5 table, it's $165. That's substantial. As well as, even, you know, you did have, you know, the instances where Never Bust was losing, you still had basic strategy doing better. In only 2 of the shoes did Never Bust outperform basic strategy. So I'm not recommending any system. I just don't think that we were able to come to anything conclusive. And like I said, 7 shoes isn't enough. However, on some of the other systems, I feel fairly comfortable, for myself at least, of saying this system does not satisfy me, because after 7 shoes, it it definitely didn't perform well, especially when we had a better mixture of shoe performance, which we sort of lack here. So, you know, I'm not gonna tell you, I can't tell you not to play Never Bust. I don't think I would. I kind of don't like it. I like the idea that you can still, you know, according to basic strategy, still improve your hand. And you know, you see it a lot. You know, you the 12 to a 10. If you assume that the dealer has a 10, and you know, however whatever percentage of the time they will, you know, you didn't even try to win. That's my approach, personal. You play your way with your money at your own risk. Okay, so this was, you know, eye-opening. Like I said, I learned I'm not going to try to run shoes in parallel again. It's not worth it for me. It's not worth it for you. I mean, that's the first shoe got, you know, the most number of thumbs down, and that's fine. You know, I kept it because the data was still there, and we were able to, despite the mistakes, you know, figure out how to adjust the chips a little bit. So, you know, it's fine. You know, I'll take my lumps. And some people just gotta hate. So, anyways, that's how it came out. You know, I know there's some of you who really, really believed in this Never Bust. It didn't work for us here. You know, maybe over, I want to, you know, first of all, I'm going to take the summer off, so I won't be back for until September, making videos. Maybe I'll do a few more, you know, maybe and try to get a better look at it. You know, it's a lot of work setting up the shoes this way. So, you know, making you know, shuffling one and then doing it again. You know, and I keep getting from one particular viewer, you know, complaints that my shuffle procedure is not accurate, does not represent a proper casino shuffle. You know, I haven't yet found any backing reference material for that other than just what this person says. So I'm going to keep going with the way I'm shuffling. I'm using a procedure that is, you know, published by someone who at least claims to be a dealer. The only thing that's different, I'm used the riffle machine. Just saves on my cards, and I'm not that good at it, so it's faster. I think that it gets reasonable results. And I don't necessarily agree with that idea of choppiness in the shoe. I think that once you get enough players at a table and people playing in random ways, and things going on and on and on, and if you when you just come to a table, you have no idea how long it's been running, and what the people that were there half an hour were doing, or how many positions there were, and you know, and most people, and perhaps there are some rare, very gifted people who are able to use that kind of information, card tracking, to their advantage. Your average user, or player, you and me, you can't do it. When you sit at the table, sometimes you watch people come up and they watch for, you know, a few hands, or something like that, and then they all of a sudden they go, okay, oh, now the table's hot. I'm gonna get in. You watching for five or six hands, that doesn't tell you anything. Personally, I just like to get in, sit down, start playing. I usually play long enough that the highs and lows, you know, kind of average out. If I start heading down, I'll keep playing because, you know, eventually, usually, you get things turned back up. You know, it can get hard, and at the same time, you know, and this is where, you know, discipline comes into play. When you start getting up, you should walk away rather than waiting for that fall to come. And you know, so when you go down, what are you doing? You're chasing the dream. You're trying to work your way back up. When maybe you should walk away, maybe that's better. But as far as like being able to predict what card comes next, I've been trying to think of a way to conduct a test like that. But I guess I have to do it in a way that the the shuffle is satisfactory. And of course I would show it, but if anybody has any thoughts on that, please share them in the comments. And again, so thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe. I know I was saying a few extra things there, but that's because I'm going to be away for a bit. Of course, if you're watching this several months later, you know, time will pass and you won't even know. But for the regular viewers, thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe. That way you'll know when I'm back on it come September. And if you are watching this, you know, recently, currently, enjoy your summer, okay? Thanks. Bye.